the brakes and don't change that dial. When the ASA Speed Truck Challenge comes to California, the hits never stop and the excitement never ends. It's road course time. Next up on O'Reilly Auto Parts Motor Mania. Welcome to Fontana, California for the ASA Speed Truck Challenge presented by TVT 24/7. Hi everybody, I'm Doc Riley along with Bill McLeod as we get set for the sixth stop out of 13 on the ASA Speed Truck Challenge.
There's a good shot of the 07 truck owned by Austin Murphy, sponsored by Frazier Masonry and Lucas Oil. And this S10 ran like a bat last week.
One of the top rookies in the series. This is a good look at the number two truck, James Griffith, the Kawasaki of Reno S10 as well. Let's take a look at our starting grid on the pole. The number three ride of Bear Resnowicki and the United Nissan Quaker State S10. Another one of those top rookies. So far this season, he has been the top rookie in three of the five races. This is the second time we've gone road course racing, a 1.5-mile road course. The last time these guys took to the track, it was at Firebird Raceway on a 1.7-mile road course. Interesting that the ASA Speed Truck Challenge road course is kind of in the middle of the season, but they're run back-to-back, Bill.
That's right, Doc. And Jay Rutherford, the president of ASA Speed Truck Challenge, knows that these drivers enjoy the road courses, but there is a special setup that they have to do with these trucks. And he knows that it's time and money, money that sometimes they just don't have. And that's really what makes the ASA Speed Truck Challenge so special, Doc, is because all these drivers get to experience not only oval course racing, but great road track racing.
And road track racing, very important if you want to be a well-rounded driver. We'll tell you all about the trucks and their setups. It's designed so they're all very, very even. Not many things you can monkey with. This is a series where it's all up to the driver, and a premium is placed on the driver being able to negotiate this 1.5-mile road course. As we get set to go green, the number three ride of Bear Resnowicki, the United Nissan Quaker State S10, will bring him to the green flag. An awful lot of drivers. Patience is another key in this tour. Resnowicki brings him through in the number three ride. Running in second right now, Scott Franchimone in the 01. That's a nice look at Colorado. Currently in third, Darren Young, the United Nissan Sudden Impact S10. He started fifth and he's already made up some ground.
You got to know that these drivers are just now trying to feel out the track. They're feeling good out there right now, but they're reaching some good top speeds. But they don't want to do anything silly. They want to stay with the power of the truck and keep it on the track.
Patience is a key. Very close course racing. Hoosier tires are what they're all riding on. From the first to the last competitor, they're all riding on the Hoosier tires. You've got to be able to take care of those, and that is going to give you a little bit of patience. But man, I tell you, one guy who's got all kinds of patience is Bear Resnowicki. He is our race leader. He's a rookie, and he has been tough. Darren Young was our winner from Firebird Raceway on the other road course. These guys are really letting it all hang out here. King trying to make up some distance. French Money, your leader. Resnowicki running second. King in third. And Catlin running fourth. Again, on the road course, so very, very different than running your ovals because you've got the left and the right-hand turns. You cannot get in a hurry here. If you burn up the tires, you're going to end up being in last place. A rookie leads the field.
That's what really makes the difference here is because these guys know oval track racing, but they've been put on this road course. It makes them better drivers. It makes them alert, and they can do amazing things with these trucks if they just keep a control of the power.
We have six rookies starting this field out of 24 drivers, and these rookies are really a class bunch of individuals, both on and off the track. And Resnowicki shows the way. In his rearview mirror, he has got the 01 ride of Scott Franchimone, who's in that Colorado, currently running in second. Lap number two on track as we go back on board with the number one ride of Mr. Catlin. And he's starting to make his way up through the field. As you notice, making those corners, trying to stay in contact, keeping that same line, hitting those marks. Very difficult here on the California Motor Speedway road course. Now, most people know that this brand new track in Fontana, California has hosted a number of great cup races. Very few people know that it's got a nice, challenging road course right in the infield.
It really is one of those unsung heroes of road course races, Doc. We came out of Firebird International that has a rich history of road course racing. And right here on the infield of the oval at California Speedway is one of the finest road courses that you see anywhere.
Flat road course, lots of turns, no hills to be involved with. Boy, look at this, a little battle going on as we look up the rear of the Young's ride. Darren Young won at Firebird Raceway, his first victory of the year. We've had five races with five different winners, and we've got ourselves a battle going on here as we look forward out of the number 35 ride. That's Randall King. So King and Young are having themselves a battle. And that battle is currently for third place on the track.
You can see right here that although they're racing really hard against each other, oh, there's some debris in the track that they have to maneuver over. And that's always a possibility here on these road courses as they hit some of the dividers that go around the track.
And that's really nothing other than some plastic. Sometimes you get those barrels and you'll knock the bottom part off of it. The ASA Speed Truck Challenge officials are right on top of it. We'll have more racing from Fontana coming up. Stay tuned. O'Reilly Auto Parts Motor Mania is brought to you by O'Reilly Auto Parts, home of the professional parts people. By Mallory Ignition, the ultimate performance system. And by TVT 24/7, a major breakthrough in lubrication technology designed to save your engine and the environment. Welcome back to the ASA Speed Truck Challenge presented by TVT 24/7. Our leader right now continues to be the young rookie Bear Reznowicki in the number 3 Chevrolet S10.
ASA Speed Truck Challenge, Doc, is in its 12th racing season, and it will be seen right here next year on Outdoor Channel. And it's exciting to think that we've got these rookies heading into what could be a great points championship for next year.
Yeah, and rookies as young as 14 years of age. Not many touring series allow rookies to compete, but these guys really make a good name for themselves. On board, we look forward to see what Mr. Randall King has to see. That battle continues as he continues to wear out the bumper on the truck in front of him. One good thing about the ASA Speed Truck Challenge, there's no bumping and grinding here. They really do it professional on track.
That's right, and President Jay Rutherford knows that these drivers love to get out there and mix it up. But he maintains a no-tolerance policy when it comes to rough and aggressive driving in his series.
That's the way it should be. You teach drivers some good habits, getting right into it. These guys are really going all out. That's Darren Young. And now we're on board with the 35 truck, Randall King. As you notice, these drivers coming into this little right-handed turn, then into a quick left-hander, really shows you some outstanding truck control.
That's right. Unlike his past driving, race officials tell me that Randall King has totally changed his driving style here in 07. He's driving calculating, he's confident, and he makes sure that he keeps his truck out of trouble.
Well, that's what you have on a series that tests everything from some very, very small oval tracks to some large road courses like in Firebird, where Darren Young picked up the win. That's a 1.7-mile road course. This is a 1.5-mile road course. And again, this one, some little tougher twists and turns. And boy, we've got ourselves a great battle up front. But Bear Reznowicki in the number 3 ride continues to hold down that top spot. The battle right here is between King and Darren Young. And Darren Young's a teammate of Bear Reznowicki, correct?
They are. They both run for the United Nissan team, and they just feed off of each other. You can feel the excitement in their pits when they talk about this racing. And the 43-year-old Darren Young, two-time past champion of the ASA Speed Truck Challenge, has a lot of experience to give to the 15-year-old Bear Reznowicki.
And it's got to help when the 43-year-old Darren Young ends up winning at Firebird, his first victory, that on a road course, not the last time the ASA Speed Truck Challenge took to the track. Beautiful road course. We've got some pretty tight battles going on as we work now on lap number 7. Bear Reznowicki in the number 3 continues to pace the field.
Remember, Doc, these are two-speed direct drive transmissions, and boy, these drivers really push the RPMs on those Van Gordon Racing V8s.
And that's interesting because all of those engines are sealed. They're spec engines, one of the things that the ASA Speed Truck Challenge does to keep costs down and to keep parity up. We're on board right now at the 5th place. That's Jeff Catlin.
Oh, that's Randall King, almost losing that corner, pushing the rear end of Young.
You keep the pressure on if you're running behind. Oh, look at that. Right in front of him, the number 2 ride. That's James Griffith in the SBC Yellow Pages S10. Good battle there in about mid-pack. We have a good confrontation shaping up here in the number 1 and 2 position as Bear Reznowicki continues to hold down the lead, and he is being paced by Scott Franchimone in the 01 ride. Back on board with Catlin as we continue to look at that tough, tough battle. Catlin in the number 1 truck. Right in front of him, the number 2 ride, that's James Griffith. Look at your top five. Reznewicki, the rookie, continues to lead here on lap number eight.
Frenchmoan's had a great season so far, but he's really pushing the edge right here. He knows that he's got to stay with Bear every single corner, but his truck's really pushing around the edges, and I'm a little afraid that he's getting loose.
And getting loose is just a little bit of rubber, some on-track debris right there. Taking some evasive action, that's Paul Bonacarsi on the 84.
Oh, Doc, we've got a truck off the track.
Off the track, that appears to be the 39 ride of Angelo Gilotti in the Truck Graphics Dakota. Let's go on board here as we see some agricultural racing. That the number one ride of Jeff Catlin. Tough when you have to take evasive action, maybe get off course a little bit, and then get back on and still remain in contact with the truck in front of you.
Great avoidance driving there by Jeff Catlin to avoid that wreck.
And that can be tough as well. Think about the concentration. You've got to be able to handle your truck, not wear out those tires, keep in contact with the guy in front of you, not worry about the guy behind you, and have some very good patience. Patience is the key. Jeff Catlin involved in the battle for fifth place. James Griffith right now holds that position down in the number two S10 truck. Lap number nine, and Bear Reznewicki continues to show the way. Boy, I'm really impressed with this young kid. There's a little bit of that debris. That's just the bottom off of one of those barrels. It's a little hard rubber, but guys may try to avoid that so they're not using up those Hoosier tires. You see right there a little brake dust coming off as they get hard onto the binders. Still having to avoid that vehicle that's off track. That's the 39 ride of Angelo Gilotti. And we've got problems right now as Catlin continues to go off-road, and he's able to pick it back up to get on track. Gilotti in that Truck Graphics Dakota just parked right there. He's going to be done. He'll be the first person to retire in this race, and he'll finish up in 23rd position. In the number 35 ride, Randall King. He would like to visit Victory Lane. We've had five different races so far this year and five different winners on the ASA Speed Truck Challenge.
Doc, looks like we've got a yellow caution flag out on the race course right now.
Yeah, we do, Bill. They're going to take care of Angelo Gilotti, get his truck out of the way. Stay with us. We'll have more racing from California Speedway right after this. Back to the ASA Speed Truck Challenge presented by TVT 24/7. We are underneath caution, but we are set to go green. Bear Reznewicki in the number three ride. That rookie brings them down, waiting for the starter's orders. The green flag is out. We're back to racing.
Oh, look at Darren Young. He has jumped out in front of Bear Reznewicki, and he's just overtaking him right there at the finish line.
Hey, I tell you, Young is a very tough driver, seasoned driver. He picked up the win at Firebird on the road course last time we all got together, and now he is out.
Wow, look at, he has taken the lead, Doc. Look at that move by a veteran driver.
It's amazing to me, a veteran driver. Restarts are so critical, so key. He really timed it perfectly. Again, these are a two-gear transmission, and he probably right on top of his game. At lap number 11, the 18 ride of Darren Young, the United Nissan Sudden Impact S10, paces the field.
There's nothing like being a veteran, and you saw it right there in excellent driving, being able to jump that restart. He didn't do it illegally, mind you, but he got onto it just at the right time and was able to overtake the leader.
I can tell you, he didn't do it. He was very, very close, and that is a fine line there. But the ASA Speed Truck Challenge officials, Jay Rutherford, the gang, if you would have jumped the start, they would have caught it.
That's right, they would have.
These trucks all evenly matched, spec engines running on Hoosier tire, Torco fuel, and it's all up to the driver. And as we see, Darren Young is the man. Now his teammate, the young rookie, is running second. That's Bear Reznewicki. And in third, Randall King. Kind of feel good if you're the team owner of United Nissan. And that team, Darren Young, your old school driver, who's got all that experience, he's outpacing the field. He's got a win underneath his belt. And Bear Reznewicki, that young rookie in the number three, boy, he's really going to school.
And here we are on the TVT 24/7 on board with Paul Bonacorsi. And man, he's having a great race today. He's only raced one other time this season with the ASA Speed Truck Challenge, but he's really showing these guys how to run this course.
Yeah, he's up there in the top five looking for positions. He's running up against James Griffith. I'm very, very impressed with his driving ability. It's not an easy venture to get out here and run in a road course with a good mix of veterans and rookies. You take a look at our leaders right there. Just a few trucks separate number one from number two. We're working lap 12 here at California Speedway, stop number six of the ASA Speed Truck Challenge. Randall King currently running in third, James Griffith in fourth. And we start to see the number 80 ride of Victor Pfluger starting to make a little bit of progress through the rest of our field.
What's really exciting, Doc, is we've got two rookies that are making their way up as well, and that's Jeff Catlin and Tim Allen.
Tim Allen in the 77 ride, that's a Dodge Dakota. He's a guy to keep an eye on. At the front of the field, Darren Young continues to lead. Bear Resnowicki runs in third. Let's go on board now with the 84 truck. That's Paul Bonacorsi of Bonacorsi Racing. That's a Dodge Dakota. In front of him, James Griffith. That's the number two ride. That is the Kawasaki of Reno Chevrolet S10 position. As you see, all of our drivers nose to tail up here with that front pack of five. Oh, a little smoke as these guys are going bumper to bumper right there. Bonacorsi gets by.
Oh, there was a pass by Bonacorsi. Just got by Griffith. And that's a fine piece of racing right there. For our viewers, you know that it's all about timing, and that was a perfect piece of timing right there.
Yep, no bumping and rubbing. You just wait for that opening, and he took it. Bonacorsi with a nice bit of driving, and right in front of him right now, the number 35 ride, that's Randall King. So Bonacorsi, new to the series, new to this road course race, and he is really pushing hard right now, running in the top five.
Randall King's not letting the pack get away. He is running a strong third, and he's going to stay right in there on the heels of Bear Resnowicki.
Young, Resnowicki, King, Bonacorsi, and Pfluger all make up your top five here as we continue to run through the laps in California. Now, does it look as if that young rookie is starting to put a little pressure on his mentor and teammate?
It does. Remember, we've gone through several laps here now. The trucks are really warmed up, but so are those tires, and they're getting a little bit looser through those corners. And so now's the time to really pick your spot in order to pass.
Bonacorsi wearing out the rear bumper of the King right in front of him, looking for that opportunity to pass. Again, there is a no-tolerance policy on bumping and running, so it's got to be clean all the way through. As they come back into this particular corner, every single driver looking for that advantage. The only guy who really doesn't have much on his mind is Darren Young. The laps are starting to wind down, and we have a caution on the track. We will have our restart, wrap things up, bring you the winner's circle as the ASA Speed Truck Challenge continues here on the Outdoor Channel. Motor Mania is brought to you by O'Reilly Auto Parts, home of the professional parts people. By E3 Spark Plugs, Diamond Fire Technology, Energy, Efficiency, Ecology. And by NRG Resources, advancing alternative energy. Welcome back to California Speedway, the ASA Speed Truck Challenge presented by TVT 24/7. We are set to go green. Pacing the field, Darren Young in the 18 truck. We look ahead right now. The position one tailgate right there, that is the number three of Randall King. Green flag is out and we are racing. This a good battle right now for four. King right out in front. Pfluger, the 80 truck, we're looking out of his front. Right to the left of him, Bonacorsi.
Oh, he takes the position away from Bonacorsi right in the perfect time at that corner.
Boy, I tell you, when you've got a veteran like that, you just have to be patient and look for your spot on the racetrack and go ahead and take it.
There's the Victor Pfluger that we all know of this series. I'm telling you, the kid is awesome. He's already pushing the third position of Randall King.
And Pfluger has one victory, that on the Tucson Oval earlier this year. Boy, they're all over the place. These guys are just looking for that one little inch on the track where they can get by.
They know that this race is almost over. The checkered flag could fall at any time. It's a timed race. It's not a lap race. And they are pushing for all it's worth right about now.
The man that continues to push out front, Darren Young. Young picked up the win at Firebird. He's looking to sweep the road courses. There are two road course races on the 13-race ASA Speed Truck Challenge. And Pfluger continues to work, looking to the inside. Can he pull off the pass there? Not going to happen this time.
Whoa, King was looking for a place to pass there and just couldn't get by.
Unless you're Young, you're trying to make a position. Look at that. Young, Resnowicki, King, Pfluger, and Bonacorsi. That's your top five. It starts to wind down. Young out front. Boy, we're making a move right here on the inside as Pfluger gets a little bit out of shape, but he still maintains position. Lap 16. Young paces the field in his S10. His teammate, Bear Resnowicki, right behind him. That's the rookie, Randall King, currently running in third. But that battle, and we'll get back to it, Pfluger going to try to get back onto King and pick up some points on the ASA Speed Truck Challenge.
Things are so tight on this part of the course. it's just impossible to get around these guys if you don't get a mistake made in front of you.
Yeah, and one little bobble could cost you. As they continue, nose to tail racing through the balance of this field. And as we have said, a timed event here, so that checkered flag could come at any time. Pfluger's lost a little bit of ground here, but one thing is for certain, once they come out of a turn, he can put the hammer down and close that gap between his truck and Randall King's Colorado.
Oh, Doc, we have a caution on the course, and we are going to, yes, we are under caution.
Caution has been out and the time coming back down, so our ASA Speed Truck Challenge officials will have to huddle. And now we find out the race will end under caution. Let's take a look at what brought out that yellow flag as we're on board with Dallas Kolodny. Looking back, and he is just along for the spin and makes a little contact there and comes to rest. So that's part of the caution problem that we see. We do have another angle of it. This from Andy Allen's ride. Allen and the R.J. Allen Colorado.
Yeah, Kolodny just gets turned sideways there, and Allen had nowhere to go but just make the contact.
And contact is made. That'll bring it back out. Those guys will finish towards the bottom of the leaderboard and a tough break. At the top of the leaderboard, a team is very happy as the United Nissan Sudden Impact and the Quaker State team finish first and second. Darren Young claims his second victory on the ASA Speed Truck Challenge.
Yes, and Randall King, last year's Rookie of the Year, had an excellent finish in third position. And Sean Steele gains eight positions and leads the Stagger Pro 1000 Hard Charger Award.
Congratulations to him as well. Let's go to Victory Lane now and Steve Guccione.
Tell us about that last restart with your teammate over there.
I'll tell you, both these United Nissan trucks were fabulous. For whatever reason, I think they must have started in second, and I started in first. As soon as I got on the gas, it launched, and I was just so surprised about. I was able to pull like right up on them really quick, so I pulled out and continued on. I didn't know if I had jumped the start or what the deal was. As soon as the green came out, I went, and it just launched past them. So it was a gear call. There it was. I just had a better gear for a restart.
Better gear for a restart. Hey, look at these guys at Victory Lane. Teammates having a little fun. You want to learn more about the ASA Speed Truck Challenge? Go to speedtruck.com. This has been a presentation of Masters Television in association with the Outdoor Channel.